kinks, it is nappy foo all up on your screen, and it is skin time. I'll be talking about some of my favorite masks and my current routine that has been helping me with my acne. Y'all ready? Nappy foo checking in. Lego.
So it's kind of about my skin drama, pretty much. You know, I know I'm not the only one in the world, but sometimes it does feel like that. Sometimes I feel like I'm the only one who's skinning like this. Even though, I know it's not true, but this is how a person feels. I've been battling with a bad breakout that just doesn't seem to want to go the hell away. It's stressful, it's hitting my esteem, and that's one reason I haven't done videos lately, but I said, you know what? I can't hide forever. And my story just might help someone. So here's a little bit of what I've been going through with my skin. This is my skin drama.
And the award goes to Nappy Foo for being overly dramatic. I mean, I promise y'all, when I recorded this video previously, I was like, I just want people to feel what I'm going through. So let me just make sure my voice is low like this. And, you know, I just be extra for no good reason. Anywho, that time was a journey, y'all. So if you don't know about my skin journey, this is the first video I posted about it. Make sure you check out my playlist. I have a playlist about a lot of good topics, okay? But today's about skin time. So make sure you check out my playlist about my skin journey, dealing with adult acne, and many other things. Check it out, y'all, on my channel, okay? Have it all laid out for you. You know what I'm saying? See, look, I have about, 12 videos y'all can check out? When you have time, click play. Thank you in advance. My first favorite acne mask is Clay's, using Clay's. Razzle, Bentonite, Choline. Whether I use it together or I use them individually, works wonders when I stay consistent. I have to throw that out there. If I've been falling off for several months, I see it in my skin, okay? But when I stay consistent with using Clay's, whether on my skin or on my hair, I notice the difference. I reap the benefits of it. But of course, when you're not doing it consistently, you're not reaping those benefits, right? You know what I'm saying? So what are these benefits you talking about, Nappy Foo girl? Let us know, please. Spill the beans. I will spill it through. Are you ready? Okay, so bentonite clay, y'all. Bentonite clay is the star of the show, in my opinion. It helps with any skin conditions like eczema, and it targets acne. If you have clogged pores full of toxins and other kind of gunk that's just on your skin, not paying any rent, set that bentonite clay on it, and it will pull it on out, okay? It attracts dirt and toxins out of your pores, leaving you with a smoother texture. It also helps to reduce swelling in the face. Like if you have excessive sodium, it helps to reduce that, helps to tighten your skin for immediate smoothing effect. Choline clay is the next heavy hitter. Now there's other colors. There's many colors of choline clay, but I've only dealt with the white one. And the white choline clay is very gentle, so it's very ideal for any sensitive skin, and it helps with dry skin as well. Last but definitely not least, we have Razzle clay. And Razzle clay is a very strong and beneficial clay to wear that to the place that is even used in mineral makeup. Okay, it's good for both hair and skin. It also helps to remove most positively charged toxins. It promotes elasticity and helps in texture improvement, and is actually good for everyday use. All these clays will do all this for you, of course, when used consistently. What is consistent? I was told by an esthetician at least once a week or every 2 weeks. And hence, speaking of once a week, that's the average of what I post. So hang out with me, y'all. Join Team Kinks. Hit the subscription button and the bell right next to it so you are notified the next time I'm all up on your screen. Thank you. My next favorite mask for my acne is what they refer to as a fruit pack, a fruit mask, basically a mask made of fruit. Okay, I tend to find myself drawn to banana, avocado, honey, and strawberry quite a bit when I make these masks. If you want me to make a dedicated video on how I make it, I'll be more than happy to let your girl know in the comment box below, okay? But what are the benefits of putting the fruit directly on your face? It's natural. You know exactly what you're putting on your face because it's something you eat, okay? And something else about fruits is that a lot of the enzymes, a lot of the acids, a lot of the antioxidants that are in these fruits are also part of the ingredient list that you see in some of these expensive facial products. A lot of times it's extractions of these fruits, not the actual fruit, like extractions of it, okay? I'm gonna need her to stop eating. So that's something else about these fruits. You will not go hungry if you are doing a fruit pack, okay? I'm just saying, anywho, but no, yeah, a lot of these enzymes, acids, a lot of them come from fruits like this. You ever heard about papaya? If you haven't heard about papaya for your face, check it out. Do your research. But overall, y'all, these type of masks that I've been doing consistently, at least, once a month, once or twice a month, I have seen improvement in my skin. So there has to be something to these DIYs. Give it a try. Now, the number one new thing to my routine, I would say, is that I did finally break down and go see a professional because I had another cystic breakout that was very similar to the beginning stages of my journey. And I was like, not today, not today, Satan. So I went and saw a professional, and that's when I definitely learned more about clays. I learned more about acids, using different type of acids, antioxidants, and things of that nature on your face. So there has to be something to it, because it wasn't until I became more consistent with these type of stuff that I started to see my texture improve. Now, Sal C toner is something that my esthetician recommended for me. Sal C ain't nothing but salicylic acid, okay? It's a little cute name they gave to this bottle. The brand is Face Reality. Some of these products you do have to have a prescription to get, but some of them you can get straight online. So I will leave the link for you in the description box. Check them out. But salicylic acid is supposed to help with texture improvement and to prevent the onset of acne. Mandelic acid is derived from bitter almonds. Hello, isn't that a food item? I'm just saying. I'm just saying. So this is a alpha hydroxy. It's a bit more gentler than glycolic acid, if you happen to know what that is. It helps with wrinkles, fine lines, and for me, it's helped with my hyperpigmentation and discoloration. She also gave me a moisturizer called Crayon Peptide Cream. The key component in here is the peptide and the antioxidants that this gives me. Helps with anti-aging benefits, but most importantly, it helps to get my skin acclimated to the benzoyl peroxide spot treatment that she gave me. So it prevents my skin from getting too dry when I use that treatment at night. Now, I don't show you this in this video because I don't use it often. I honestly still use my Desert Essence acne pen that I've showed y'all before. I still use that when I have a pimple coming on. So make sure you check my previous videos so you know what pen she's talking about. It's all up in those videos. Something else I stepped up on is my SPF. I now use the level 30. I used to use like 10 or 15, but I've learned the importance for African American skin using 30. Now, these bags, y'all see, it's still a work in progress, okay? So I recently started using more consistently the Ordinary Caffeine Solution 5% plus EGCG, which is actually derived from green tea. And I like to use my e.l.f. Massaging Eye Wand, which is so relaxing, y'all. Like, so relaxing. So I've been doing this for the past few months. I see some improvement, but we're not there just yet. But I am hopeful that I will get there. So that is my quick little update on a few things I am doing differently this time around. My first acne video was posted almost 5 years ago. So my skincare routine now versus then is different, and I want to know what is different about yours. So let me know. Let us know in the comment box below. What is your skincare routine now versus what it was, let's say, about 5, 10, whatever years ago? Trust me, your answer will definitely help another natural out. Thanks in advance. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please go ahead and help your girl out by hitting that subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell right next to it so you can be notified the next time that I am all up on your screen. Also, if you're bored during the week, come on and hang out with me on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, all of that, all of that. And I will catch you on the next one. Now, everything we went over today, kinks, is what I like to do externally. But we all know what matters most is what you do internally. Okay? We'll talk about that in another video. Till next Sunday, remember, y'all, in order to have healthy skin, hair, mind, body, soul, everything, you got to do healthy things consistently. Happy food checking out. Deuces.